Hi, I'm Landon with Spartan Controls, and today I'm going to show you how to do the bench step procedure on a Fisher 667i Actuator. Like all procedures, we should start out by making sure we're wearing proper personal protective equipment for the job at hand. To begin, we want to ensure that our actuator is secured and disconnected from our valve stem. In this case, I have it secured in a vise, but if it was mounted to a valve, you want to remove your stem connecting block before you begin. Next, you'll check the bench set rating on your actuator's nameplate. Next, we'll connect our air supply to our actuator and then increase our air pressure until our actuator reaches the upper travel stop. Next, while slowly decreasing the regular pressure, notice the pressure at which the actuator starts to move downwards, leaving the upper travel stop. In my case, the actuator stem started to move downwards above the bench set rating, so I'll remove my actuator pressure. And then decrease the tension on my actuator spring. Now that we've verified that the actuator leaves the upper casing at the correct pressure, our last step would be to verify the stroke of our actuator. To do this, you'll stroke your actuator up to the upper casing using your regulator. And then, using a scrap piece of tubing, I'll insert it through the vent hole in the casing and then mark that tube. Next, I'll decrease my regulator pressure to my lower bench set value, then reinsert my tube and mark the actual stroke. The actual measured travel should match the rated travel of the actuator by plus or minus 10%. If it all matches up, you're good to go and install your actuator on your valve. If it does not match up, there may be a mismatch between your bench set, actuator travel, and spring. And this concludes our overview on how to do the bench set procedure on a Fisher 667i actuator. Thanks for watching.